Welcome to Everything Computerized. I'm CA and today in this video I'll be going to explain you the basic concept of tables, databases, database management systems, relational database management systems and SQL. So without wasting much more time, let's get started. Please vote my way of explanation by tapping on the info card above. Save the playlist Basic SQL Tutorial for Class 10 and 12 so that you do not miss out any video that might be important for you. In the previous video, I have shown you how to install MySQL to run SQL queries on computer. I have given the link in the description and in the info cards above. If you haven't watched that video, you can jump to that from here. So let's start with the tutorial. To understand SQL, we first need to understand some basic concepts. So let's first understand what is a table. So a table is a collection of related data in an organized manner in the form of rows and columns. Here is a simple example of a table containing the data about different students, that is their ID, name, age, and course. Each type of information present in the vertical position are known as columns or fields, and the data of each student is known as row or record. Each record holds the total data for a specific student. In this way, we can make as many tables as possible with the different combinations of different data. As you have understood tables, let's take a look at the definition of table. A table is an organized arrangement of data and information in the tabular form containing rows and columns, making it easier to understand and compare data. So as we have understood tables, let's understand what are databases. So simply, a database is a collection of multiple tables in a single container. We have a type of database known as relational database. So when a database contains multiple tables which are related to each other in a specific manner, then that database is known as a relational database. Databases are stored on computer and so can be easily modified. So as we have understood databases, let's take a look at the definition of the database. A database is a large collection of data or information, specifically a large number of tables organized in a way in which it can be easily updated or accessed with a computer system. Now we have understood what are tables and databases. We all know that we need a software, or basically an app, where we can do things. Similarly, in order to make a database, edit a database, or anything related to a database, we need a software. This type of software that deals with the databases is known as database management system, or DBMS. I hope you have understood what DBMS is. So now let's take a look at the definition of DBMS. A DBMS or a database management system is a software package designed to define, manipulate, retrieve, and manage data in a database. It helps the users to store and retrieve data. Retrieve data means accessing the data that is stored so that you can display or copy it. You may have heard about RDBMS, or basically Relational Database Management System. So RDBMS is nothing but just a type of DBMS that deals with relational databases. So a DBMS or a database management system is a software that works with databases. But we know that these softwares could not work on its own. We have to give instructions to it on what is to be done and how it is to be done. Consider command prompt. It is a software in our computer in which we write commands and execute it to do a specific task. We write commands in a specific way and in a specific syntax. Similarly, in a DBMS, when we need to do a task on a database, we give commands. And these commands are known as SQL, or structured query language. So SQL is nothing but it is simply a programming language, that is a set of syntaxes and rules which helps us to give instructions to the DBMS software to work with databases. So indirectly, SQL helps us to communicate with a database through a database management system. Like we have C, C++, Ruby, Java, Python as programming languages, SQL is also a programming language. There are many database management system softwares which could be used to manage databases, but they all use a common language, that is the structured query language or SQL. I hope you are quite clear with the concept of SQL. Now let's take a look at the definition of SQL. It will help you understand it in a better way. Structured query language or SQL is a computer language for management of databases and data manipulation. SQL is used to query, insert, update, and modify data in a database. It contains a lot of commands which a user can execute to perform operations on a database. So this was a brief concept of tables, databases, DBMS and SQL. In the next video, I'll explain the different components of SQL that are data definition language, data manipulation language, data control language, and transaction control language. Don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.